Alzheimer's disease stands as the predominant form of dementia, constituting an estimated 60 to 80% of dementia cases. This condition primarily impacts the brain regions responsible for thought, memory, and language. It can significantly impact the affected person's ability to perform routine daily activities. This progressive disease typically initiates with mild memory loss and may advance to the point of impairing the individual's capacity to engage in conversation and respond to the environment. Alzheimer's is a condition that tends to evolve over time. It gets worse over time and ultimately is fatal. In the medical world, researchers have worked tirelessly to identify and outline different stages that describe how individuals transition from normal cognitive function to advanced Alzheimer's disease. Every person with Alzheimer's experiences the disease differently, but people tend to experience a similar trajectory from the beginning of the illness to its end. The precise number of stages of Alzheimer's is somewhat arbitrary. Some experts use a simple three-phase model, early, moderate, and end, while others have found a granular breakdown to be a more useful aid to understanding the progression of the illness. A thorough understanding of the distinct stages of the condition is beneficial not only for healthcare professionals in devising customized treatment plans for patients, but also for patients and caregivers in effectively addressing challenges that emerge at different phases of the disease. The most common system, developed by Dr. Barry Riceberg of New York University, breaks the progression of Alzheimer's disease into 7 stages. This guideline is used by professionals and caregivers around the world to identify at what stage of the disease a person is in. Stages 1 to 3 are the pre-dementia stages. Stages 4 to 7 are the dementia stages. Stage 5 is the point where a person can no longer live without assistance. Let's take a closer look at the 7 clinical stages of Alzheimer's disease, which are also referred to as the Global Deterioration Scale, GDS. During stage 1, individuals remain unimpaired, with no noticeable memory issues, and such symptoms do not become apparent during a medical interview with a healthcare professional. Even in stage 2, only very mild cognitive decline is present, like some typical age-related changes, or the earliest indications of Alzheimer's disease. People may occasionally experience memory lapses, particularly in forgetting common words, names, or where they've placed everyday items, like keys or eyeglasses. However, these issues are not noticeable during a medical examination and usually go unnoticed by friends, family, or colleagues. In stage 3, we're looking at mild cognitive decline. At this point, early stage Alzheimer's might be diagnosable in some, though not all, individuals exhibiting these signs. It's the stage where friends, family, or coworkers start noticing these differences in cognitive ability. You might see issues with memory or concentration that can be measured through clinical assessments or spotted during a detailed medical interview. These issues may include having a hard time finding the right words or names, something close friends might notice, forgetting names when meeting new people, having trouble in social or work situations, which your family, friends, or coworkers might pick up on, reading something and not retaining much of it, misplacing or losing valuable items, struggling with planning or organizing things. Stage 4 signifies a moderate cognitive decline, which is indicative of mild or early stage Alzheimer's disease. At this stage, a comprehensive medical interview would reveal clear-cut deficiencies in the following areas: diminished knowledge of recent events or current occurrences, impaired ability to perform challenging mental arithmetic, such as counting backward from 100 by sevens, reduced capacity to handle complex tasks, such as shopping, planning dinners for guests, or managing finances and bill payments, a decline in memory related to personal history. Affected individuals may exhibit a subdued and withdrawn demeanor, particularly in socially or mentally challenging situations. Stage 5 represents moderately severe cognitive decline, indicating the mid-stage of Alzheimer's disease. At this point, noticeable gaps in memory and cognitive function surface, necessitating some degree of assistance with daily activities. Individuals in this stage may struggle to recall crucial information, such as their current address, telephone number, or the name of their high school or college, even during a medical interview. Experience disorientation regarding their whereabouts, date, day of the week, or the current season. Encounter difficulties with moderately complex mental arithmetic, like counting backward from 40 by 4s or from 20 by 2s. Depend on assistance for selecting suitable clothing for specific seasons or occasions. They generally maintain substantial self-awareness, recognizing their own names and the names of their spouses or children. Typically retain autonomy in tasks related to eating and using the toilet. Stage 6 marks a significant cognitive decline, signifying a moderately severe or mid-stage of Alzheimer's disease. During this phase, memory issues worsen, and noticeable personality changes may appear. Individuals at this stage require extensive assistance with their daily activities. In this stage, they may forget recent experiences, events, and even their surroundings. Recall their personal history with loss, though they usually remember their own names. Sometimes forget the names of their spouses or primary caregivers, but can typically recognize familiar faces. Need help getting dressed properly. Without supervision, they might put pajamas over their daytime clothes or wear shoes on the wrong feet. Experience disruptions in their normal sleep patterns. Require assistance with toileting tasks, like flushing the toilet, proper wiping, and disposing of tissue. Face increasing episodes of urinary or fecal incontinence. Display significant personality changes and behavioral symptoms, such as suspicion, delusions, believing a caregiver is an imposter, hallucinations, seeing or hearing things that aren't there, or compulsive, repetitive behaviors like hand-wringing or tissue shredding, tend to wander and might become lost. At this stage, it's crucial to provide support and care for those affected by the disease. Stage 7 marks the very severe cognitive decline, which corresponds to the severe or late stage of Alzheimer's disease. In this final stage, individuals progressively lose their ability to respond to environmental stimuli, maintain coherent conversations, and ultimately, control their motor functions. While they may still occasionally utter words or phrases, their condition significantly deteriorates. Individuals in stage 7 require extensive assistance with essential daily activities, including eating and toileting. Furthermore, they experience a decline in motor functions, which manifests as the loss of the ability to smile, sit unassisted, or hold their heads upright. Abnormal reflexes, muscle rigidity, and impaired swallowing are common features. This stage represents a profound challenge and necessitates specialized care to ensure the well-being of those affected by this advanced stage of Alzheimer's disease. The rate of progression for Alzheimer's disease varies widely. On average, people with Alzheimer's disease live between 3 and 11 years after diagnosis, but some live 20 years or more. The degree of impairment at diagnosis can affect life expectancy. All right, I hope this video has helped you gain a fundamental understanding of the 7 stages of Alzheimer's disease. In future videos, Derek will provide more information on how Alzheimer's disease progresses. If you have any questions on this topic, wish to delve deeper, or would like to share your experiences, we encourage you to leave a comment and engage with us. If you found this video informative, please consider liking, subscribing to our channel, and sharing it with others. This will help us continue to provide valuable information on health and well-being. Thanks a bunch for watching and stay tuned for the next one. Wishing you enduring health and timeless beauty.